News out of Europe, the government's at the NATO defence ministers meeting, Pat Conroy confirming 49 Abrams tanks to go to Ukraine. Do you welcome that?
Absolutely. The coalition welcomes this announcement. We want to see Ukraine supported with the hardware she needs to actually fight this unjust war against Russia. And so this is absolutely a welcome announcement, particularly as this particular hardware is going out of service for our IDF. It's great that it can be reutilised, repurposed for the Ukraine in their ongoing battle against Putin.
Yes, indeed. And another battle, a battle by democracy against the terrorist groups, Hezbollah and Hamas. What do you make of that US demand this week issued to the Netanyahu government to start allowing more supplies into Gaza or lose the military support?
Well, I think the US obviously, like everyone, is concerned about civilian casualties throughout the war. The fact that Israel has stumped up for support to Gaza, humanitarian aid at the beginning of the conflict. Remember, there was concerns that this support would be siphoned off to actually away from those who actually needed it on the ground to support Hamas. There was concern about access into the Gaza Strip. So as long as that can be done with appropriate measures so that you're not supporting terrorists and you are delivering humanitarian aid, of course. But Israel's number one focus should be actually protecting her borders, protecting her citizens and protecting her right to exist, not just from Hamas, but from now Hezbollah and more broadly Iran.
On a couple of other matters, very different to what we've been talking about, there's been a fair bit of focus on the sleepy beachside town of or the beach area called Copacabana on the central coast of New South Wales.
What a name.
The Prime Minister's bought a place there. Great name, great song, Barry Manilow. And but what's your view on the house purchase? It's been called tone deaf by Jane Hume, but shouldn't he be allowed to set himself up with his new partner?
Well, I think the Prime Minister's been trying to remind Australians for a long time that, you know, he grew up in a Housing Commission home. He needs to be reminded that millions of Australians are struggling to pay their rent, are finding it impossible to buy a home. And right now, this decision obviously flies in the face of that. You've seen his backbench get very restless. You've seen his cabinet ministers now polishing their CVs. I mean, the home is gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. It looks like a forever home to me, Kieran. I mean, a new wife, a new home that's not in the seat of Grindler. For me, that speaks volumes and I think really attests to the reasons why you see so much agitation within the Labor Party behind closed doors around what are they doing about negative gearing, what a poor decision this was by the Prime Minister. So I think on a whole lot of levels, this decision seems to be great for his private life and his future retirement, not so great for being the Prime Minister. It's about time he started acting like the Prime Minister instead of pretending still comes from the Housing Commission home.
Well, it's had a decent amount of advertising. Maybe its Airbnb popularity might go through the roof. Just quickly on the Queensland election, it looks like the LNP ending their time in the wilderness, the political wilderness in Queensland. Could be an issue, though, for you if you win the next election on the nuclear front. Chris Afulli doesn't look like he's sold on it.
Well, Kieran, if, you know, we are lucky enough to hold the energy portfolio post the next election. We've been unequivocal. We will be moving to end the Commonwealth moratorium on nuclear power generation and get on with building net zero nuclear energy for our future way beyond 2050. You know, states will have their own views about that, but they can't ignore what will be a clear mandate from the Australian people that they want to see reliable and affordable energy for decades to come as we head into this century. So I think it'll be a very different conversation, shall we say, with the Queensland government should the LNP come to power, and should we have the great privilege to have a Dutton Little proud government post the next election.
Bridget McKenzie, thanks. I know you've got to get to the airport. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Kieran.